Hey, what is going on, everybody? My name is Barbell, and welcome to my walkthrough of The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. I've played this game so many times, it's actually ridiculous, but what can I say? It's an awesome game. And I figured I'd do a walkthrough because why the hell not? So it should be a lot of fun. And speaking of the walkthrough, as of now, it is going to be an indefinite type thing, and by that I mean, as of now, it does not have a predetermined ending. I will be sure to go through the main story, the Mage's Guild, and all the DLCs, being Hearthfire, Dawnguard, and the newest, which is Dragonborn. So I will go through that. I'm not sure exactly when. I think Dawnguard unlocks at level 10. I'm not sure about Dragonborn, but I won't necessarily do those immediately after they unlock. But I will definitely get through all of them. While I ramble on here, I'm actually going to start the new game. As for our character, we will be doing a mage type. I will be using all the schools of magic except for one. Or should I say I'm on the fence about it. And that school being illusion magic. In my experience, I found illusion magic to be really useful when you're on your own. But I'm unsure if I'm going to recruit a House Carl to come along with me or not. House Carl being someone like Lydia or Jordis the Sword Maiden from Solitude. I don't know. I typically play on my own because the less people you have with you, the less people there are to draw the aggro from your enemies, which means it's all focused on you. So you better know what the hell you're doing or you're going to get stomped. And trust me, I've gotten stomped a lot. But I've gradually started to learn how to do things. And like I said, I found illusion magic is really good when you're by yourself. Calm spells especially. You got that crazy barbarian guy charging down at you with his axe and he's ready to hit you with a power strike. You are going to get wrecked. But if you use a calm spell, he'll suddenly stop and become your ally for, I think, 30 seconds. Which is invaluable, especially if you have several enemies at once. You might be thinking that's what frenzy spells are for. But more often than not, I found if the enemy is already onto you and you use a frenzy spell, they won't care about the other people around them. They will come straight for you anyway. So that's more of a sneaky thief type skill.
Finally awake.
Hopefully you can hear me over this guy. He,
trying to cross the border,
this guy's terrible.
Right?
He just never shuts
right
up. Kind of like me right now.
Same as us.
But anyway. Yeah, frenzy spells I found are more
Skyrim
of a thief skill because you want to be in sneak mode and way away from your enemies when you unleash that frenzy spell. That way they will not find you and they will suddenly turn on each other. There's also, I think it's a fear spell. That's basically where you just cast on your enemies and they will run away rather than become your ally. They'll just run, I don't know, away from you, that's for damn sure. And I've never actually used those because I don't think they would be very useful. God, it's hard to think with these guys talking. Also, I'll typically let the NPCs talk, but I want to make my points real quick while I have a chance during this opening scene. Because it is rather lengthy. Anyway. So yeah, I'm on the fence about illusion magic. We have a little bit before recruiting a House Carl is even an option, so that'll be plenty of time to make the decision.
Why do you care? A Nord's last thoughts.
Yeah, I do have a few mods installed. Nothing game-changing or, should I say, game-breaking, making magic overpowered or anything. I'll be sure to show you guys that during the character creation screen.
Sure. Mara,
a few things I can think of off the top of my head are blood retexture, that's no big deal. Follower tweaks, just makes the followers a little more intelligent, I suppose. And if they block your path, you have a way to get around them rather than having to fushroda them down the cliffside and possibly never hear from them again. And why is this guy staring at me? That is kind of creepy. Please stop staring at me. Thank you.
This is hell.
Anyway, I'm really excited to get this started. I don't actually use mage characters very often. My playstyle is more of a sword and shield type thing, where I'm all up in the enemy's grill and just slice and dice, slap chop. But, yeah, I felt like doing a mage for this walkthrough. Should be pretty interesting. Of course, the difficulty will be on master. Because anything less is just no fun. Anyway, we have been captured by the Imperials during an ambush of the Stormcloak Rebels. We are here in Oh shoot. My brain is running a blank on the name of the village. I'm pretty sure Roloff said it too.
Let's go.
Helgen, that's right. We are currently located in Helgen, and we are gonna get real friendly with that chopping block over there.
Face your death with some courage, thief.
The guy in front of us in the cloak is Ulfric Stormcloak, the leader of the rebellion. This thief is just a random thief.
Empire loves their damn
list. And this is Rayloff from Riverwood, who does not shut up ever.
Ulfric Stormcloak, Jarl of Windhelm.
Oh yes, leader of the rebellion and Jarl of Windhelm. Jarls being very similar to kings of certain provinces within Skyrim. Excuse me.
Care of Rorikstad.
No, I'm not a rebel. You can't do this.
Halt!
You're not gonna kill me.
Oh shoot. I'm sorry about that. Shoot.
Feel like running?
Wait.
Took a drink of water and it went down the wrong pipe.
Step four. Who are you?
Hello there, Hadvar. Okay. Hadvar is also from Riverwood. Man, I need to catch my breath. Okay, I apologize about that. That happens to me all the time where I take a drink and it just goes down the wrong pipe and then I just sit there coughing for like 5 minutes. Okay, so our race is going to be a Breton. Known for being mages. But one thing I do like is their resistance to magic. I'm pretty sure that's a passive resistance of 25%, I think. I've never been a fan of using powers, but Breton's power, as you can see, is Dragon Skin, which is a power to absorb spells. So we're going to go ahead and go with Breton. Oh, need to use my mouse. Body, sex, yes please. Very funny. Either male or female. And I'm not too big on playing as female in games. That's just my own preference. So we're going to increase the weight. Try and make it somewhat similar to mine. Unfortunately, as you increase the weight, it doesn't just increase muscle mass, but it also gives them a very large beer belly, mega super gut, so I'm gonna go with that. That looks about right. Okay, let's move on. Hey, look at us. There we go. Complexion, we are young. No dirt, scars, war paint, yes. I'm typically a fan of this war paint, but I might go with this one. Almost every single character I've created has this war paint. I don't know what it is, but I really think it's cool. Yeah, let's go ahead and go with this. War paint, always red. Blood red. There we go. Face, I'm pretty sure none of this is worth modifying. Right. Eyes. Leave the eye shape alone. Eye color, we're going to go with... I'm pretty sure that was it. Very, very light blue or gray. Not like it really matters, because how often do you see your character's eyes? Well, let's go with gray. Eye height, eye width, none of that matters. Brow, I'm pretty sure none of that matters. Mouth, I'm pretty sure none of that matters. Hair, that does matter. And unfortunately, I am not a fan of any of the hairstyles in this game except for this one. I keep my hair rather short. Or should I say this one? I keep my hair rather short. Definitely not this short, but nothing else really looks appealing in this. Unless you like to have mega greasy hair, then, well, more power to you. Yeah, we are not an old guy who is balding. Yeah, let's go ahead and go back to that really short hair option. That'll work. Facial hair. Definitely not mutton chops. there we go, a little scruffy scruff. Hair color, blonde. More of a goldish blonde. I don't know why I'm getting so in-depth with this. That looks about right. I don't know. I'm suddenly not digging the hair. Should we go with this one? Nah, that's fine. Let's just go with that. Okay. Finish and name the character. Yes, the name of our character is Emest. I think it translates to serious. I'm not sure what language that is, but it doesn't really matter. I just thought Emest sounded cool, so let's go ahead and go with that.
You from Daggerfall, Breton? Fleeing from
I will sometimes
court
refer to him as M because,
Captain,
I don't know, that's a short, cool name.
He's not on the list.
Forget the list. He goes to the block.
By your orders, Captain.
Anyway, Emest here.
We'll make sure your remains are returned to High Rock.
Was attempting to find this rumored College of Winterhold so he could study magic. Unfortunately, as you can see, he was captured when he got into the middle of a Stormcloak and Imperial battle. No excuses, apparently, because we tried to tell them that we had nothing to do with it, but here we are in Helgen anyway. So the Imperialists really show mercy and understanding. Emest will definitely remember that.
You started this war, plunged Skyrim into chaos, and now the Empire is going to put you.
This is General Talius, the leader of the Imperials inside of the Skyrim. I was going to say the Skyrim province, but I just said the Skyrim. That's weird.
It's nothing. Carry on.
Yes, General Tullius. Give them their last rites.
As we commend your souls to Aetherius, blessings of the eight divines upon you.
For the love of Talos, shut up and let's get this over.
Well, apparently this guy is anxious to die.
Come on! I haven't got all morning.
Very anxious.
My ancestors are smiling at me, Imperials. Can you say the same?
Oh.
You Imperial bastards!
Justice!
Death to the Stormcloaks!
As fearless in death.
Oh, there's Raeloth. I was wondering where he was.
Next, the Breton!
Surely you don't mean me.
There it is again. Did you hear that?
I said, next prisoner.
Hey, let's prisoner. Let's not nice be hasty things. Here. Oh, okay. Shouldn't you guys clean up the first body? I mean, this is kind of weird. I'm kneeling on top of a body here. And his head is still in the basket. Mine's just going to roll out, guys.
What in oblivion is that?
Sentries, what do you see?
It's not in the clouds, it's right there on the keep. Well, that executioner was a puss because he just fell over dead for no reason. Yes, let us go, Raeloth. Whoa! Okay, that was kind of awkward.
What is that thing? Could the legends be true?
Legends don't burn down villages.
We need to move now.
Yes, I agree.
Up through the tower. Let's go. Let's go. Upstairs
now. Yes, let's go.
Let's go.
Yes, let's go.
And keep going.
Go. You sure about this?
We'll follow when we can.
All right, here I go. Right. Our feet got a little toasty there on that fire, but it looks like we're okay.
Just walk towards me. Hammond, you need to get over there. Now!
Batta boy, you're doing great.
Toral!
Good job, you didn't get yourself killed.
Everyone
you're doing great.
Prisoner, keep close to me if you want to stay that way.
Gunnar, take care of the boy. I have to find
you know, Alduin, if you just stayed in the air, you could have roasted us all alive. But no, you just had to land over here and then shoot your fire at these wooden planks.
Stay close.
Good
to
job.
The wall. Quickly, follow me.
We can't pick up any of these weapons because our hands are bound.
Into the keep, soldier. We're leaving.
It's you and me, prisoner. Stay close.
Okay. By the way, seeing those mages back there. Oh, one second.
We're escaping, Headhunt. You're not stopping us this time. Fine. I hope that dragon takes you all to Sovereign Guard.
Oh, snap! You got launched into orbit. Alright, we're gonna go with Rayloff because the Imperials kind of, I don't know, tried to cut our heads off. So I'm not exactly itching to go with one of them into the keep alone. And yes, this will take forever to load because my computer can't really handle recording games like this too well. But hey, what can you do? Oh yes, I was going to make a point. I saw those mages back there and that reminded me that we're going to be a storm mage. By that I mean we're going to use lightning spells only. Well, except for the beginning here because right now we only have flames as our only destruction spell. But later on in the dungeon we will acquire sparks. And that will be our main focus of attack for the rest of the game. There's three elements. There's fire, ice, and then there's lightning. I think the lightning is the coolest. It does cost the most magic.
Looks like we're the only ones.
But we should be okay.
That thing was a dragon. No doubt. Just like the children's stories and the legends.
No doubt.
The harbingers of the end times. We better get moving. Come here. Let me see if I can get those bindings off.
Oh, thank you.
There you go. You may as well take Gunyar's gear. He won't be needing it anymore.
Very well. Warax, no. I'll take the Curious and the Fur Boots. He can have the foot wraps and the rough spun tunic. Okay.
Get that on and get that axe.
That's not useful. Let's go ahead and favorite. Yes, I know. Go ahead and favorite these things. We do not actually have enough magicka for this first concentration spell. That's kind of lame, but what can you do? Okay. Active effects. Yes, a passive 25% resistance to magic. That is very handy because I always get completely. Oh, I forgot. I always get completely destroyed by mages in this game.
Ah, this one's locked. Let's see about that gate.
I don't know what it is, but mages in this game just always wreck my world. Especially frost mages. They slow me down, and since I use sword and shield a lot, I'm gonna hide behind you so they focus on you. The frost slows you down, steals your stamina. Ugh, so annoying when you're trying to attack with a sword and shield. Go after Rayloff. He's dangerous. Oh, no? Okay.
Damn.
Okay, we got one down.
Right.
Oops.
You've had enough.
Got our magic recharge while Rayloff goes ham on the captain. This is the one who ordered our execution, despite the fact that there was a dragon lurking about. Thanks. Oh yeah. Nice kill cam there.
Maybe one of these Imperials.
Really? There's the key. I do have a certain set of rules, I suppose, when it comes to looting. I always have a 10-to-1 gold to weight ratio requirement. At least 10-to-1. And by that I mean if an item has 1 weight, it has to be worth at least 10 gold or more before I pick it up. That way I can really maximize the amount of inventory space I have. There's another Helgen key in there. And this area right here is where you come in if you choose the Imperial side. Oops, that's empty. When I get to rambling, I don't notice things like chests labeled as empty. There should be some gold over here. Yes. There's Railoff in the background telling us, hey bro, unlock the door. It's like, yeah, chill out. I'm trying to get the money and stuff. You're missing out, Railoff. There's cash money everywhere.
Unlock that door. Let's get... That's it. Come on. Let's get out of here before the dragon brings the whole tower down on our heads.
Now that is a good idea. There he is. Mouse 2 to block. Alright, well, since we're not using shields.
Damn, that dragon doesn't give up easy.
Grab everything important and let's move. Dragon's burning everything to the ground.
Sounds like we have some friends in here.
Just need to gather some more potions.
Alright, we'll let Railoff. Okay.
Stormcloaks.
I'm not a Stormcloak, I just happen to be here. Man, what a way to go. Let's just move that down there. Yeah, nothing for us here. Definitely take that, take that, take that. Look at the magic potions, the health potions. Not much use for the stamina potions, but we will take them in order to sell them. Another health potion. I think that's everything in here. Yeah. All right, let's go.
Done. Let's get moving.
Here. Okay.
Come on.
We have a fellow mage down here. Who is completely oblivious to us lighting his back on fire. That's impressive, I gotta say. And now we get to be completely useless because our magicka is gone.
Show me what you
got. I was trying to sneak in a little fire right there.
No, I haven't seen him since the dragon showed up.
Ugh, these people are dying in such weird ways. Okay, we're gonna take that. See, this has a weight of 6 and a value of 75. It had to have a value at least of 60 in order for me to take it, but this has exceeded that, so I'm going to take it. Alright. We could care less about Ulfric right now. Thanks to him and his crew that we got captured and nearly executed in the first place.
It's locked. See if you can get it open.
Yes. Yes. Oh. Oh. Here we go.
Some picks.
Anything in here? Might no, but it did have free experience. Man, I am sucking when it comes to predicting these locks.
Grab
right now.
Anything useful and let's go.
I know this is not a sneaky thief type character, but getting more experience in lockpicking is handy because there are a lot of locked chests around. Anyway, there's our shocks, or our sparks, spell tome. And we got our robes. Should help us with our magicka regeneration and overall magicka total. There we go. And novice robes, novice hood. I think now we can afford to spend, or not spend, but cast our conjuration spell, so let's go ahead and hotkey that. I'm gonna put that to 3, put that to 2. There we go. Now we are a proper storm mage. That's right, I missed something in here. Got a potion and a few lockpicks. Excuse me. Oh, come on. There we go, and we got our level up in lockpicking. Decent progress towards level 2. All This one has a coin purse in it, and I think a few gold coins on skeleton. Yes. I'm pretty sure there's only two locked doors here. Yeah. Sorry, Raylof. I'm trying to gather all the resources I can. Nothing. Some gold. One gold. Wow.
Imperial dogs. There's nothing that's too low for them.
You need to clean your face.
Just keep putting one foot in front of the other.
Oh, so that's how you walk. I had no idea. I love being a smartass. Yeah, you tell me to hurry up, and then I'm like 6 years in front of you waiting.
Orders are to wait until General Tullius arrives.
I'm not waiting to Sounds be like more Imperials dragon. Ahead.
Just give the general
time to go ham. Shocking. And this guy's after us. Get away from us. And there is the problem with storm magic. Very magicka. I don't know. It uses a lot of magicka. That's what I'm trying to say. And it doesn't do extra damage like fire does. But it is really, really badass in my opinion. So that's why we're using it. The messed here needs to get back to the fight. Oh, these guys are dead. Have no fear, we are here to help. Oh, she got wrecked. Oh, point blank arrow to the kidney. Lovely. Light armor, helmet, and bracers. Armor, helmet, and bracers. Oh yes, it also reminds me, seeing all these arrows, that if we do recruit Lydia or Housecarl, they will be restricted to... Did I get the bracers? Yeah, I did. They will be restricted to using bows only. Because once they have a sword and shield, they get up right in the enemy's face. And I don't want that for two reasons. One, it will draw all the aggro onto them, meaning we just sit back and just blast them with spells, which I suppose is effective, but it doesn't really seem like we're the hero in that situation. And the second reason why is when our house carl's up in the enemy's grill, our spells will more than likely hit her, or our housecarl, can be him, will hit our housecarl more often than it will hit the enemy we're aiming at. And that's because they tend to like to get in the way, because that's just what they do. So we're going to restrict our guard to bows only, because we want all the glory, but we also want somebody around just in case we need a little bit of help. What are you turning around back there for? I'm up here.
That doesn't go anywhere.
You sure?
Better try this way.
Don't give me your crap. Ugh, spiders. Let's take care of these fools real quick. We do not want those nasties getting in close to us, because their jumping bite attack is mega powerful when you're at a low level. We do not want none of that. Did that thing have a silver garnet ring on it? It did. Wow. What could a spider possibly need a silver garnet ring for? Oh well, I'll take it. Yes, yes, we're right here. Let's go ahead and grab this coin purse.
Hold up! There's a bear just ahead. See her?
Really?
I'd rather not tangle with her right now. Let's try to sneak by. Just take it nice and slow. And watch where you step.
Or if you're feeling lucky, you can take this bow. Might take her by surprise.
Go ahead. I'll follow your lead and watch your back.
Okay, you are definitely going to watch her back. And by that, I mean you're going to take the full force of this bear once I wake it up with some zappy zap action. Hey, bear, Railoff did it. Wasn't me. See? And now we can just sit back and zap zap. Although that's a lame way to do it, we are definitely not in any position to take on a bear right now. We have, what, like 10 armor? 6 armor and 100 health. And this is on Master. We will get completely owned by this bear. And that's actually relevant for a very long time. And by that I mean quite a few levels, you will still get owned by bears out in the wilderness. So you kind of got to be careful. Kind of got it. I think we are approaching the end. Oh, see you to start sneaking. Thanks. I'll keep that in mind if I see that bear again. Oh, wait. It's dead. Yes, this is the end of the dungeon.
Looks like the way out. I knew we'd make it.
Hell yeah. We are a good team, Railoff. That is my squeaky chair because I need a new one. I don't know if you guys can hear that or not, but if you do, that's the chair. Now, I think I'll get into a little... Let's see, what am I trying to say? I think I'll get into character more in the upcoming episodes. But for this one, it was kind of hard to do that because this is a tutorial area, and I've been through it so many times that it is just monotonous. But I tried my best to make it at least a little bit entertaining. Sorry about having to clear my throat a lot. I got my water right next to me, but it seems like every time I take a drink, I end up hacking and coughing, nearly dying. So it's either clear my throat a lot into the microphone, which I apologize for, or take a drink and possibly die. So my options are not good. and as I told you guys earlier, it takes 6 years for this to load because my computer is the suck.
Wait.
Them goofy ass eyes. That was an awkward staring contest.
No way to know if anyone else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. Better clear out of here. My sister, Gerder, runs the mill in Riverwoods, just up the road. I'm sure she'd out.
Well, thanks, Railoff.
Probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't
thanks.
Have made it without your help today.
Alright, so we're gonna head to Riverwood, meet up with Gerder, Railoff's sister. Apparently the owner of the mill.
You know, you should go to Windhelm and join the fight to free Skyrim. You've seen the true face of the Empire here today. If anyone will know what the coming of the dragon
means.
Oh,
look at that. That's actually one of the mods I have installed. Guards will actually patrol the roads. Which may prove to be invaluable if we get into trouble with, well, bears, that's one thing. Or necromancers or anything out in the wilderness, there's a chance that a guard might be nearby to help us out. And that will be very good. Anyway, Railoff here mentioned that we go to Windhelm to join the Stormcloaks. I...
ruin up there. Bleak Falls Barrow. Never understood how my sister could stand living in the shadow of that place. I guess you get used to it.
I suppose you do. Anyway, he suggested we go to Windhelm and join the Stormcloak Rebellion. We are not too fond of the Stormcloaks right now. Neither are we fond of the Imperials. It's thanks to their stupid civil war that we got captured and nearly executed. So we are in no hurry to take sides right now.
Guardian stones. 3 of the 13 ancient standing stones that dot Skyrim's landscape. Go ahead.
See for yourself.
So we have the Thief Stone, the Mage Stone, and the Warrior Stone. I think it is pretty obvious which stone we are going to pick here at the beginning. Under the sign of the Mage, those under the sign of the Mage will learn all magic skills 20% faster. Okay, so...
Mage, eh? Well, to each his own. It's not for me to judge.
Yeah, you don't seem like the magey type. No offense, of course. So you wanted us to split up, and now you're here waiting for me? Okay. There's a mine located up there. I'm gonna keep that in mind. That was stupid. I apologize. But yeah, I will keep that in mind. We will probably go back there later.
Just let me do the talking, all right?
Okay. You're the boss. Hopefully it's not too much farther to this riverwood. Whoa! You see that, Rayloff? Wow, where was that last one at? Oh, there it was hiding in the tree. Sneaky bastard.
We're almost to Riverwood.
Well, I'm glad you decided not to kill me. So, yeah, thanks for that. I still don't trust you, though. Still don't trust you. I trust you more than the Imperials, if that's worth anything to you. And here we are at Riverwood. Nice little village area. I'm going to take the opportunity to end the episode here. Hopefully I will see you in the next one and join Emest on his journey. I believe in the next episode we are going to head on up to probably that mine back there. Not sure what else we'll do. But yeah, hope to see you in the next episode, and take care, guys. Bye.